I think because when I was first reading it and I was looking at the character of Guy, there's something really interesting in him that he's the kind of unwilling hero. He's, you know, he's been a guy that's been a mercenary fighter, a hired killer, for such a long time now, and he's kind of buried everything that he's thought of in terms of life and love and everything, and he comes back to this family home where he's expected to be this hero.
I'm glad you came. Though we could have wished for better circumstances.
I'm no stranger to your circumstances anymore.
But I do think this is quite a marked moment where it becomes it, where he's not just so much a hired man anymore, but he's
yeah, we don't want you just standing.
You know, I felt like I felt like it was the uncle kind of bestowing responsibility on me.
The character I play is Joan de VC, who is the mother and wife of the family who live in the castle. She is the mother of the three children, and she's a matriarch. She runs the castle, basically. She's educated her children. She lives a very simple life in the castle.
He needs to rest.
I was really excited when I read before the part. I mean, there's a lot of action in this movie, which is great. You never really get that. These roles don't come up a lot, especially for a girl. So to get to dress up like this all the time and, you know, to fight, to horse ride, it's an adventure.
Started as a kid at school, the history lessons at school, learning about medieval world, this strange world that people did strange things in. You know, the medieval mindset was so far removed from what a youngster would look around his own world in. You know, just see the weird things, and it just some things twig inside you. And I've just always had that interest.
Let's get ready to do the chop again. Yeah. And this time, go ahead and actually do the chop.
Right. On. Yeah.
I'm going to stay in that general area.
This is Mary, your friend. Slit the throats of 12 men and cut out the tongues of three. This one, you don't mess with, brother.
I think the group of actors that are in this movie are brilliant. And one of the guys that I've worked with, you know, you've got Tom Austen, who's playing Guy. Tom Rhys Harries, who's playing Hubert. David Caves, who's Beringer. And Twinley Moore, who's playing Crazy Mary. And they're fantastic. They're really good. Whereas the Sand Serbia, they're fantastic. And I've enjoyed every minute. Brilliant.
Beringer is a bit of a mysterious chap. He turns up on the scene and he's kind of the right-hand man of Guy, who's the main part, I suppose. And we don't really know much about him other than that he's a mercenary. And both he and Guy are mercenaries. And they've been kind of going around the country, look, you know, being hired by people who are supposed to fight.
We had stunt training, but a lot of it was kind of, you know, filming up at Maglitch Castle. Like, nothing could prepare us for the terrain that we would be filming on and running on and stuff like that, you know. So there wasn't so much that we could do apart from kind of turn up and hope that we could do the choreography that we'd learned to the best of our ability.
I think you have to treat violence seriously. You know, people in the modern day film, they get shot, it hurts. If someone gets hacked by a sword, it hurts. I mean, if you sanitize this stuff, you know, kids watch it and watch it and watch it, and they think nobody gets hurt. You know, they just get up and walk away. But in real life, they don't. You know, violence is nasty. It's harsh, it's corruptive, it can eat at your soul if you're just involved in it all the time. And I think it needs to be a sort of guttural experience, if you like, you know, because it is such a harsh thing. It sounds simplistic to say a lot of this stuff, but, you know, the effect that violence has on people, it's life-changing.
Katia, do you want to put just a couple of stitches in the shirt?
Uh-huh,
just
yes.
So we can see that ripped open from here.
Not for freedom, God, no money. The money isn't why you came! You came because you knew it was right.
What do you know what is right?
I know it's blood. But we're not family.
I've got to tell you, sisters, the object.
No.
This is no time to argue, cousin.
That is why you will go with my sisters.
And I'm with you. And if we're arguing over that, then you've got to fight in your hands.
Physicality. Challenging physical-wise, not physicality. I think in terms of doing the physical aspect of a film like this, riding horses is quite interesting. I've never ridden a horse for work before. I think the last time I rode a horse was when I was 15. I lied to the director.
So as far as preparation goes, Jonathan, the director, had already asked if I'd had any skills with sword fighting. And so, you know, I lied and said, of course. I did actually used to fence, but that's obviously very different from sword fighting. So we had stunt people on set, and they were able to ensure that we were holding the swords right, and we were able to do everything. You know, you just get stuck in, don't you? You just kind of get on with it, and so it was great fun.
For me, as an actor, I've played some nasties in my time. The Executioner, I just thought it was too good. Once I was chosen for it, which was lovely, which was great, fingers crossed, lovely. It was a part too good to give up, and I won't give away too much. Sorry, but I get to do a little bit of singing.
How is a man in heaven without his head? Without his head.
I think if you spend 2.5 months with people doing something that you all have common ground in, something that you all enjoy and you all have such a big interest in, you have that level thing that you've all, you know, you all have in common already. And, you know, we are young. And so, of course, you have to become a unit. You have to become a family with all its glory.
The crew have been absolutely amazing, and we've been really well looked after. And you know, Belgrade's a great city to be in if you like to have fun.
It's actually been brilliant working here. I was really excited to come out. I hadn't been to Serbia before, but I'd had friends who had come out here to work. And I was in Bulgaria for part of last year, and so this was a little bit further afield, but still in the same vicinity, and I just wanted to be able to see the differences, experience a different culture, and people here have been amazing.